Thor: Ragnarok Grandmaster concept art reveals a more comic-accurate design for Jeff Goldblum's version of the Marvel character. Marvel Cinematic Universe films often change the appearances of characters adapted from the world of Marvel Comics. Fans may not always love these redesigns, but they're a vital part of the MCU, giving it a unique look and feel of its own. What's more, it's always intriguing to compare movie characters to their comic book counterparts. Thor: Ragnarok made some big changes from the comics, not only with its narrative but also the way that many of its characters appear. Characters like Hela, Scourge, and Surtur looked like they were pulled straight from the page, yet different Hela designs and alternate versions of Surtur were considered during pre-production of the film. As for the Grandmaster, he looks remarkably similar to his comics counterpart save for one key feature: his blue skin. However, it turns out that the character was even going to have that feature at one point during Ragnarok's development. Marvel concept artist Jackson Zee has revealed his first design for the Grandmaster, showing off a very accurate take on the villain when it comes to his comic book appearance. You can check it out below. One of my first takes on the Grandmaster: my co-worker at Constantina Ascaris did the final design you see in the film. When doing the first designs for existing characters, we always look to the comic sources first. Hashtag Ragnarok, hashtag Thor, hashtag Marvel Studios, hashtag Marvel Cinematic Universe, hashtag Grandmaster, hashtag concept art, hashtag concept design, hashtag character design, hashtag digital art, hashtag digital painting, hashtag illustration. A post shared by Jackson Zee at JS on December 8, 2017 at 11:04 a.m. PST. Ultimately, the Grandmaster was brought more in line with his brother the Collector and likely meant to look separate from the similarly blue Kree. While some fans may have been disappointed with the small change to the eccentric Rogue, it's hard to argue that director Taika Waititi and Goldblum didn't create a highly entertaining foil for the heroes. Here's to hoping the Grandmaster and Collector do indeed team up in the MCU one day. From the overlord of Sakaar to its citizens, many MCU fans have wondered why the drab and zombie-like residents of the planet from Guardians of the Galaxy look so strikingly different from the colorful characters in Thor: Ragnarok. While it's safe to assume not all Sakaarians look and dress the same, Taika Waititi provided a more entertaining reason when a fan brought up the issue on Twitter. Well, as every true Marvel fan knows, Sakaarians wear reversible clothes: gray, rugged, and scary on one side, colorful, festive, and flamboyant on the other. https://t.co/yjh9 Taika Waititi at Taika Waititi, December 7, 2017. True to form, Waititi isn't stumped when it comes to criticisms of his film and remains dedicated to having fun with the property above all else. The idea itself is an amusing one and certainly adds another layer of humor to any rewatch of the original Guardians of the Galaxy movie. Sources: Jackson Zee, Taika Waititi.